Hello everyone, welcome back to another video. My name is Deyanira Cavazos and I am an LPC associate here in the state of Texas. I'm so happy that you're here today. I ended up taking a little break from making videos here on this channel just to take some time to self-care and to just continue to build a routine for myself and just, you know, live life outside of making content, and that was really refreshing. It was much needed. I ended up getting both of my COVID vaccines. Quick little update. So that was its own thing. The fatigue is real, but I'm so relieved and happy that it is done and that I am back here talking to you all. First of all, thank you so much for all of your kind and encouraging comments on my videos and who have DM'd me. I know I haven't been making new content, so I didn't expect it at all, and it means so much. I'm just trying to, as always, make the kind of videos that I would have wanted to see and that would have been helpful to me. So I'm just so encouraged to know that it does that for you. So thank you so much for taking the time to do that. I am so happy that you're here. But moving into the topic of today's video, I am going to be walking you through a weekend reset routine for me as a counselor, the things that I do to self-care, to rest, to recuperate, and to just get ready for the start of a new work week. Now, the reason why I wanted to create this video is because if I could go back in time, travel back and tell younger me anything, back when I was an undergrad, it was to take self-care very seriously and to prioritize it. And a reset routine usually, I feel, involves a lot of productivity in the sense of getting a bunch of things done, but my reset routine also involves self-care and within that rest and all the things that I'm going to be talking to you about and showing you today. And I hope it inspires you to create your own self-care and reset routine to get you started. And it's not something that you have to wait to do until you're licensed and working. You can start incorporating this when you're in undergrad, when you're in grad school. Self-care is for everyone and at any time, right? But it's so important for us as therapists and therapists in training to take care of ourselves, because yes, we've heard it told to us so many times, but it is so real. If we do not care for ourselves and take time to recuperate, to recharge, and be compassionate to ourselves in that way, we will have nothing to give from and we will end up burning out. It is such a huge reality when we hold spaces for others. It's so important to hold spaces for ourselves. So with all that being said, let me go ahead and show you my reset routine. So once the weekend comes around for me, which is usually Friday evening, because I usually stop seeing clients around 6, 7 p.m. depending on the week, what I like to do is gather up all of my work things, my books, everything that I utilize, and pile it up in a little section and just let it be. So that way my mind knows that work is over and it is time to start my weekend. And along those lines, of course, I have to change into some comfortable clothing, because that is something that helps my mind recognize as well that it is time to move along, get comfortable, the day is done, and it's time to start enjoying myself and doing some of my favorite hobbies. Once I've taken a sufficient amount of naps and I've rested, I usually like getting to cleaning the apartment and organizing things, because when I have a nice clean environment, it just feels more restful for my mind. And I feel like in adulthood, at least where I am now in this stage in life, cleaning is something that I find to be very relaxing to me, because I know that the outcome is going to make me feel better. And it always helps if you have a good playlist going in the background. At least for me, I cannot clean unless I have a good movie or a good playlist going. And along those lines, while I'm cleaning, I also like to start food prepping. And I don't food prep for every single meal. Right now I'm currently food prepping usually for breakfast and lunches, and eventually I want to get into dinners, but I feel like that's just where I am right now. Sometimes I do a food prep, sometimes I do a meal prep. It just depends what I'm feeling like. But at the end of the day, I just try to make it something enjoyable. I try to find interesting recipes, and that definitely helps motivate me take my lunch break and just just enjoy the lunch that I prepped for the day. Now, also expanding on that, the weekend is usually when I do one of my second grocery runs, and that usually looks like me picking up curbside or sometimes going in store if I have a little bit more time. But to be honest, it is usually curbside. I order my groceries online and then just go pick them up. I feel like I wish I would have had that when I was an undergrad and the beginning of my grad school experience. It would have saved me so much time, so I love having that now. Now, some of the more recreational self-care activities that I do on the weekend to help me rest and just stay mindful, for one, is plant care. It's something that I've done for a couple of years now. I love taking care of my houseplants. I have them all behind me right now. I take time to water them, to prune them, do little plant chores here and there. I have a whole other dedicated channel to my hobbies and things like that. That's where I pretty much started off first, just enjoying my own self-care time and sharing it with others. So that is something that I still hold very near and dear to me because it helps me reconnect back to who I am and not just the part of me that is a therapist and that is working with clients. I try to reconnect to who I am, what I enjoy, because when we have this consistent pattern and long time pattern of feeling disconnected from our own bodies, it's just so much easier for us to be susceptible to burnout and to not remember what it was even like to enjoy the things that we once did. So yes, lots of plant care, lots of rest and naps, and also I like to get some movement in. I just recently ordered an elliptical machine. I've been working out at home with my elliptical and I have loved it so much. Really good for my own mental clarity. It makes me feel so good and in tune with my body. And then also another part of my own self-care is also just spending time with family and reconnecting with them, hearing how they're doing. All of these things helps me just stay out of my work brain and just connect with the world around me and other things that are going on, and the things that are going on in my loved ones' lives too. But that is it for my little weekend reset routine. I really hope you enjoyed it. And if you feel comfortable enough, definitely share some of the things that you do to reset yourself for a new work week. Thank you so, so much for watching this video. There will definitely be more videos to come. If you're not subscribed to the Keep On Growing channel, definitely hit that subscribe button and join the community on here. Thank you so, so much for watching, and I will catch you in my next video. Bye, everyone.